Hello guys, today I'm playing Dead Space 3. It's a new game that I got.
Understandably, this scares the shit out of Kurt, and he decides that maybe sleep is the best idea right now. This thing just comes out of nowhere with its clashing animation style, abstract design,
okay, solo campaign.
And soft whispering voice. There's a sense of sadness to it, like this creature knows something that Kurt doesn't. He's not perfect either. Who knows? Luckily, we don't have to dwell on that, because we have yet another fucked up moment to attend to. The last moment comes from the episode Freaky Fred. In this episode, we meet Eustace and Muriel's nephew, Fred.
I don't care about 300 years ago.
Fred likes to speak in rhyme and shame people against their will.
Okay, okay.
He's absolutely obsessed with it. When he pins down Courage and shaves him, the disturbing children's lullaby plays, giving the whole scene a serial killer escapade. In fact, Fred's entire character seems like a child-friendly way to showcase the dangers of a murderer or rapist. Someone who can't control their compulsive behavior and give in.
Alright, so, haven't played this before at all.
Which gives off a sociopathic vibe. All in all, Curse the Cowardly Dog made its name on disturbing moments. It's only right that we honor the ones that fucked with us the most.
You got the pink nose.
The vampire, the swimming pool zombie, and the ghastly grinner. Are you afraid of the dark? Just like with Goosebumps, it should come as no surprise that there is some seriously fucked up stuff in the show. Are you afraid of the dark?
He's looking for the polar bears.
They are advanced darkness. The first topic is the vampire from the episode The Tale of the Night Shift. In this episode, various members of a hospital staff are picked off one by one by a vampire
Muscat.
Taking up residence in the basement.
Alex Muscat.
Amanda discovers that in order to turn the staff back to normal, she must destroy the vampire's coffin. It turns out one of the new volunteers, Margaret, is the vampire. She reveals her true form, turning from a young redhead into a green-skinned, demonic man with sharp yellow teeth, blood-red eyes, and thinning white hair. Luckily, they defeat him by burning his coffin, causing him to spawn.
I can't do this.
And flail around desperately before throwing himself off the roof of the hospital to end his suffering. Next is the infamous swimming pool zombie from The Tale of the Dead Man's Float. The episode begins with a young boy being dragged underwater and drowned.
I can't see, I'm legally blind.
In his school swimming pool. It turns out that the pool was built on top of, you guessed it, a cemetery. They forgot one of the bodies when transferring the graves, and now he's out for blood.
What's down there?
The appearance of the pool zombie is disgusting, with its exposed red flesh and partially decomposed body sitting in the water. The thought of being grabbed and pulled underwater by such a creature is a horrifying thought, struggling and kicking as you desperately hold your breath. But no matter what you do, you can't seem to break free. Things begin to get dim. The last thing you would see is that skeletal face pulling you down. The last noteworthy moment is the ghastly grinner. From the actual name, The Tale of the Ghastly Grinner. The grinner was created as a comical character initially, but was able to come to life through
I don't understand this.
Involving microwaving the comic.
I must
not really
be dumb.
Clear how it works. The grinner is a psychotic killer clown who imprisoned his creator. Who is in the process of writing an issue where he dies. Now in the real world, his goal is to victimize and torture as many people as possible, just for fun.
How am I supposed to...
He feeds off their emotion and causes them to go insane, leaving them in a brainless, laughing, drooling mess. The character is very much like the Joker from Batman, but in a more supernatural way. While the Joker manages to be both funny and scary, the Grinner is just simply scary. But man, he is good at that.
Gosh.
Got his face erased, so we won't be seeing any.
Hold on. Oh, I figured out how to go the way that I need to. Okay. I've got this. Keep going.
What really makes this scene terrifying is how calm Rem is throughout the entire thing.
Alright, I still gotta stay that way though. Oh, Jesus.
In the episode Stiggy's Adventure, Stiggy creates the Happy Home, which invents a soul and emotion, and people are happy all the time.
Okay. Pick up the ammo. Hang on, I'm gonna turn it down. Okay, so that's done. I better not die. And I died.
How much the show got away with, to be honest. It boggles my mind. It's hard to tell where the line was drawn with the show, but there most certainly was one, as they felt the need to make an adult-oriented spin-off titled Ren and Stimpy Adult Party Cartoon. Regardless, Ren and Stimpy, in my opinion,
okay guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, even though it wasn't much, but I might do a longer video tomorrow. But I'll see you in the next video guys, have a good one.